Let's quickly have a look, because one of the standout players in the Sharks team was Peps Buthelezi. I mean, we spoke about it. I thought he was one of the standout, and rightly so. I mean, space is created by the tight five, but a guy who hasn't played, he skipped, missed the one game against, I think they played Western Province, but he stood up strong.
Yeah, exciting youngster. And I think I like what Sean has done and giving him the captaincy. You know, what I like about him is the confidence that he brings to the team. He carries well, and he always looks for that option to offload the ball, and he knows which angles to run. And that's a mark of a great player. And I think, you know, for him, he can only get better from this game. Unfortunately, you know, the Sharks team as a whole didn't give him that fun football that he deserves. And I think once you see him going forward, then you can see the better part of him. But, you know, even if the Sharks didn't play well, he's one of the standout players from the Sharks, and it just shows you the quality of the player.
He has always been a special player, and we saw that today. He really stuck into the fight the whole time. Mm. We also learned that he's probably got the longest tongue in world rugby. But the other thing is, you know, we're being harsh on you know, the Sigma Lions and the South Sea Sharks. And just looking at some of these highlights, just realizing I don't think that we've got one player in any of our franchises that's even close to 30 or older than 30.
Mm. Yeah.
And so these are youngsters being put up against the best of the Northern Hemisphere. Sometimes it takes a couple of older heads just to take the fight up and let the energy come from the youth. But we probably don't have that balance with our franchises at the moment.